So I was volunteering this one day at my elementary school with a teacher in her kindergarten class. And on this particular day, the kids were asked, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" Now, before I reveal their answers to you, just keep in mind that this was in 2015, the age of the rise of Musical.ly stars, the year when the most subscribed YouTube channel was Justin Bieber, and, if some of you remember, when everyone wanted Miranda Sings' self-help book as a birthday gift. So I really wasn't all that surprised when more than half of the five-year-olds in this class raised their hand and replied that they wanted to be a YouTuber. And I just thought, you know, when I was in kindergarten, we all wanted to be doctors and lawyers and firefighters when we grew up. Is it finally time to recognize YouTuber as a career in its own right? Well, I suppose that there's a technical term for it, a web-based producer. And a lot of these Instagram and YouTube celebrities, they like to call themselves content creators. It's easy to jump on the bandwagon and ridicule them as airheads who just sit there, film relevant moments of their lives, and somehow earn $9.90 for every 1,000 views. Why is it so easy to make fun of these internet celebrities? Why is it so easy to make fun of these online celebrities while, at the same time, wishing we could be just like them? And now that begs the question, is it really that easy to be social media famous? So I think I could answer the first question for you right away, and it's that some of these online personas make more money than people working regular 9-to-5 jobs do. They could, film 3 minutes of themselves eating crunchy frozen grapes and call it a mukbang. Bought a new set of makeup from Sephora, perfect content for a 5-minute unboxing video. Having random late night revelations, great, let's film it. And ka-ching, $25,000 in your bank account. It seems so easy for YouTubers to make money. And let's not forget Instagram stars. For example, some fitness models can make over $25,000 per sponsored post. And to put this into perspective, a waitress in Canada working full-time hours will make on average 21K a year. So little kids, they look up to these YouTubers, but their audience is not comprised solely of impressionable young children. Because youth, like you and I, and adults, I'm sure, we tune into our favorite channels, and we consume the ads that help these influencers to make their money. Their ability to reach such a widespread audience is enviable because, I mean, who wouldn't want to hold sway over millions of people all around the world? It's why we can hate on these Instagram models, yet strive for views and likes on our own posts. It seems so simple, almost as if it were a math formula. Just be pretty, take a decent quality photo, upload it to Instagram with a catchy caption, and soon enough, you'll have gummy bear vitamin companies and online fashion retailers contacting you to be their representative. But actually, I'm here to tell you that it's all an illusion, because money doesn't just fall from the sky, and as they say, you won't get that bread if you don't work hard for it. So, for some of these YouTubers and the bigger social media stars, upholding the quality of their content can actually be a full-time job. Let's see what goes into making what could be considered the Swiss Army knife in a YouTuber's arsenal, the vlog. So first of all, like writing any good essay or filming any good movie, you need to have a plan. Your content needs to fall in the range of categories that your target audience's age group likes to watch, but it can't be too similar to any of the millions of the videos already on the internet, because then you'll be deemed an unoriginal copycat. Case in point, we don't want that. And of course, you have to have the necessary equipment to film with. Above, just some typical things even an amateur should own, obviously. And you have to find music that isn't copyrighted. And editing videos could take a couple hundred of hours out of your life. But you know, your audience just loves it when you upload on a weekly or daily basis. Let's add strong will to your resume, because you have to be okay with people disliking your content and spitting on your work. For some reason, once you become famous, people think it's okay to verbally attack you on a personal level. And the sad thing is that even with all your hard work, YouTube search algorithm doesn't always promote your content to your subscribers, so you set up a Patreon account, hoping that some people will donate funds to support your channel. Eventually, maybe, perhaps, if you gain more than 1,000 subscribers and have more than 4,000 public watch hours in the last 12 months, you can apply for the YouTube Partner Program and start monetizing with advertisements. That is, if your application was successful. Suddenly, it doesn't seem so easy anymore, does it? So I guess what I'm really trying to say is that no, it's not easy at all to uphold this character or persona for such a wide online audience. A lot of people, and I'm saying little kids especially, they don't realize that so much of what they see of their favorite TikTok star's life is scripted. People forget that social media influencers' jobs are exactly that, to influence. And sometimes that could take the form of an advertisement for some big shot company, or something that promotes a political movement, or a piece of art that connects a niche community, whatever it is. Well, if your little cousin wants to be the next PewDiePie, I'm not saying that you should deter them from pursuing it as a hobby. But they should probably know that, like any other job, there are risks and costs involved. And like any other career, chasing sensationalism may not be the wisest course of action. Now, lastly, to that kindergarten class I monitored 4 years ago, I just want to say that Miranda Sings has a university degree in vocal performance, so I hope you're still doing your homework. Thank you.